Welcome to the last day of our devotional. Miss Beth is going to lead us through days 9 through 12 and the last days of the resurrection eggs. Let's go!
The next one is the purple egg. That was not quite so loud. Let's see what was in there. Oh, this is kind of, okay. This is kind of hard for you to see. But what that is a spear. Okay, now a spear would be much larger than this, but it needed to be small to fit in the egg. So what is the spear? The spear reminds us that the Roman soldiers used a spear to pierce Jesus's side when he was on the cross. Now let's look at what the Bible says about that. And again, we're in John chapter 19, verse 31 through 37. Then the Jews, because it was the day of preparation, so that the bodies would not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, asked Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first man and of the other who was crucified with him. But coming to Jesus, when they saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and immediately blood and water came out. And he who has seen has testified, and his testimony is true, and he knows that he is telling the truth, so that you also may believe. For these things came to pass to fulfill the scripture, not a bone of him shall be broken. And again, another scripture says, they shall look on him whom they pierced. Now, the Jews did not want the bodies hanging on the cross on their Sabbath. So, in order to make the deaths quicker, the Romans would break the legs of people hanging on the cross so they couldn't push up and breathe. So they did that to the two criminals hanging on either side of Jesus. But when they came to Jesus, they saw he was dead. And so they didn't break his legs. And that was to fulfill the prophecy that had been made many, many years before that said none of Jesus's bones would be broken. But they needed to make sure he was really dead. So what they did is they took a spear and they pierced his side, and out of him ran water and blood. So the blood and water had separated, showing that Jesus had died. And this was the proof that they needed that Jesus was truly dead. So they knew he was dead when they took him down. Okay, so our next egg is cream color. Now you can't hear anything in there, but there's a little something shaking. So what do you think it is? It's not heavy enough to make noise. So this is gauze wrapping, kind of like a bandage. It's cotton, soft. Now this is to represent the cloth that they wrapped Jesus's body in when they took him down from the cross after he had died. And we're going to read about that again in Matthew. So we're going to go back to Matthew, Matthew chapter 27, and we're going to look at verses 57 through 60. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who himself had also become a disciple of Jesus. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be given to him. And Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn out of the rock. And he rolled a large stone against the entrance of the tomb and went away. So, Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus actually came and asked Pilate for the body of Jesus. So they were prominent people, but they had not been outwardly, publicly followers of Jesus, but they did believe in Jesus. And so now Joseph takes a step and is brave and goes to Pilate and says, I want the body of Jesus. I want to take down his body and give him a proper burial. And so they took the body of Jesus, they wrapped it in the linen cloth, and they put it in a tomb that Joseph owned at the time. So next we have a hot pink egg. Now this is a really heavy sound. I bet a lot of people can guess what this is. What do you think that is? Here we go. It's a stone. Yes, a rock. Now I'm sure all of you know what that stone represents. It represents the stone that was rolled away from the tomb, or the stone that they had put in front of the tomb. But before we talk about it, let's look at what Scripture says in Matthew 28, verses 1 and 2. Now, after the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to look at the grave. And behold, a severe earthquake had occurred, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled away the stone and sat upon it. So, this is after Jesus had been in the grave several days. And Mary, after the Sabbath had passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary came to the tomb. And they were shocked to see. Now, this stone had been placed in front of the tomb two reasons. The Pharisees really went to Pilate and said, look, these disciples of Jesus, they're going to say that Jesus is going to rise from the dead. And they're going to steal his body. And we don't want that to happen. So we want you to put a big stone in front of it. And we want you to put guards there. And so they did that. They had guards and they had this big stone. But guess what? Nothing is impossible with God. And so when Mary and those came to the tomb, the stone had been rolled away. And Mary, Magdalene and Mary, they were kind of shocked. Now, they shouldn't have been shocked because they needed to remember what Jesus had told them. Because Jesus had said that he would not stay dead, that he would rise again. But they did not remember what God's, what Jesus had said. And you know, sometimes we do that. We can get afraid because we don't remember what God's word says. So just like we want you to be reading your word, God's word every day, we need to stay in God's word and remember what God says so that we will not be afraid, so that we'll know how to face things that come before us. And God's word gives us faith, hope, joy, courage, and direction, even when life is scary and confusing. And I know that we're all facing some kind of scary and confusing days these days. So it's all the more reason for us to remember the words that Jesus has told us. Now we have one more egg. What do you think is in this egg? And when I shake it, I don't hear anything and I don't feel anything. Listen. Let's see what's in it. Nothing is in it. That's exactly right. Because the empty egg reminds us of the empty tomb. So let's look and see. Back in Matthew 28, let's look at verses 5 through 8. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who has been crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, just as he said. Come, see the place where he was lying. Now go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and behold, he is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." And that is the great, exciting part of Easter. That is what we celebrate. It's the biggest celebration that we as believers, as Christians, have on the calendar. And that is because we celebrate that Jesus, he died for our sins, but he rose again. He came back to life. He is no longer in the tomb. It is empty. And Jesus did. He spent time for days after this. He came back to the disciples and he made appearances before lots of people. And Jesus would be with them for 40 days. And then we know because of what Scripture says that Jesus ascended into heaven. And you know what? Jesus is sitting there now. He is at the right hand of God our Father. And he is there on our behalf telling him that I died for Beth. I died for all of you AKids kids. That when you confess that Jesus is Lord and you ask him to come and rule in your heart, we can have the salvation that he offers. And you know what else? When Jesus went back to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit. So all of us believers have the Holy Spirit living in us. And the Holy Spirit is the one that helps us to do the things that Jesus asks us to do. And Jesus asks us to spend time with him every day. You know, in these days where we're quarantined and we can't go out and see all of our friends and we're depending a lot on this technology that we have, and I'm very thankful for it. But one of my favorite times of the day is when I go, my room is right in there, and I have a chair by a big window, and I get to look out at God's beautiful creation. And I love sitting there and I love talking to Jesus because Jesus is my best friend. And I love reading God's word because it's his word to me and it encourages me. And I want to encourage you, those of you that are in my class know that we talk about reading God's word and we talk about praying. We also talk about memorizing God's word. And I want to remind you that yes, there's memory verses that you guys can be working on. And I hope to maybe be sending you some in these days to come. So spend some of this time that you have at home reading God's word and praying. And as we prepare for Easter, it's going to be a different Easter this year as we can't all gather together in one group in one room. But you know what? We can all worship Jesus right where we are. And I hope that y'all have a special time of worship this week as we celebrate the risen Jesus. I love you guys and miss you. See you soon. And there is peace.